Okay, so first question. My 9-year-old son and I were wondering how the shutdown has affected your dinosaur work. Well, the shutdown slowed down our overall work, but this made me switch and focus on detail work that I can do at home with a manual tool. So, as you see, I set up the microscope station here at home, and I'm working on currently cleaning on a dinosaur arm bone from Missouri using a pin vise and puckers. Second question, is the Spinosaurus really the biggest land carnivore ever? Well, that's a simple yet complicated question because how do we measure the biggest? Is it by height, weight, or length? All of these are estimated and depends on how complete the skeleton is. So, to get a better answers, I turn to my friend paleontologist Pete Makovicki, Evan Saita, Eric Gosak, Tom Cullen, and Jelle Viersma. Jelle said the Spinosaurus has a long and narrow skull, but that's not the indicator for the total body size. Eric said Spinosaurus skull is elongated compared to more robust T-Rex, but is it the biggest? Cullen challenges if a dinosaur that likely spent the most of its time in water, does it count as a land animal? But if it is a land animal, then Eric offers that Spinosaurus is the biggest fish-eating carnivore. Overall, we all agree that Spinosaurus is a big with a sail on its back and has a charming name, but to top it off, Pete said Sue the T-Rex at the Field Museum is the biggest and the most complete theropod. The third question I have is what lived in the ocean with the dinosaurs? Well, the ocean was full of life. There were marine reptiles, including long-necked plesiosaur, short-necked pliosaur, dolphin-like ichthyosaur, and then there were sharks, fish, turtles, crocodiles, lots of vertebrate animals. And then there were invertebrates, ammonites, belemnites, scallops, oysters, snails, sea lilies, starfish, sea urchins, and crabs and lobsters.